I'm trying to do a better job with these videos, and perhaps I'll make them shorter. You can get to the essence a little quicker. What I am seeing is another layer of clarity of what the problem really is, and that is simply we do not know that we are deserving of what I call the problem-free realm, the death-free realm. Basically, what I'm saying is that the option to relocate to the death-free realm, the problem-free realm, is on the table, absolutely on the table. 3D is on the table, 4D is on the table, the problem-free, death-free realm is on the table. It's up to you. But the whole issue is one of deservedness, feeling that this is too lofty of a goal to be talking about. And what I'm saying is it is not too lofty at all. It is in fact exactly what you deserve. This is what the trouble is. Trying to convey this is the trouble. So I have to keep at this. It is so important. First of all, salvation is 100% through what's called the grace of God. Even that's a misterm. But in other words, we don't need to do anything to deserve it. Nothing. We don't need to do anything at all in existence to deserve. It doesn't matter at all what you have done, what your adaptive survival mechanism, we call a person, etc., has done. Totally irrelevant. Totally 100% irrelevant. You deserve to dwell in the problem-free realm. You absolutely deserve that. As actually a halfway house, which is easily translatable back to the fullness of reality. Why do you deserve it? Because you are one with reality. You're a child of reality. You always have been. So that's what you deserve. Inherently. There's nothing you need to do to earn it. Nothing. To learn about it. No, nothing at all. So right this very moment, you 100% deserve to dwell in the problem-free, death-free realm. And to relocate there. 100% deserve it. And there's no way you can lose that deservedness. There's no way you can do it. It's just that very few can accept this. I'm getting closer and closer to accepting this. And you can know by just a dropping away of awe. And the feeling of awe is like someone who you're in the presence of someone who's more deserving. That's the feeling of awe. There's no one who's more deserving than you are. Nobody. No aspect of spirit is more deserving than you are. And that's very tough for some people to wrap their minds around. To get their acceptance up to that clarity. It's not easy here because belief, this whole hypothetical scenario, places value on learning, on becoming, on surviving, on adaptive responses that are, some are good, some are bad, some lead to better survival, some lead to less survival. And we're totally conditioned to look at ourselves in a judgmental way and believe that our value is based on how well we rise to meet the crises and challenges of existence, etc. But remember, existence is just a hypothetical scenario based on the false, mistaken notion that reality is going to be annihilated at some point. And we're trying to learn how to resolve this problem of annihilation. And we think we're saving reality and saving God, when in fact, God knows perfectly well there isn't going to be any annihilation of reality. So this is all entirely unnecessary, what we're up to, which means there's no way we can earn anything here in this unnecessary hypothetical scenario. We can't earn deservedness. We inherently are deserving. We're deserving to experience perfect safety. So I know I'm deserving. Why? Inherently so, not because of anything I've done. All I've done is try and discard all that which says I need to earn it. That says I don't deserve it yet. I have to wait and work more. I'm trying to discard all that and get through that delusion. It's not a big deal at all. There is a way to get to this perspective of seeing it as just a matter-of-fact situation. Oh, okay. I deserve to be here, and this other is nowhere at all. It's totally unnecessary. And you don't think that somehow you're more important or better or more special, anything like that. You just say, this is truly what I deserve based on what I was created as. Period. there is a way to get there, and I'm touching on it right now. And this is what needs to be conveyed more and more and more, because really it's the sense of unworthiness. It's the sense that this is some super high goal. It's really the only goal there is. It is only the remedy there is. And it's not a high goal. It is simply what we deserve. Because all sense of threat is an imaginary hypothetical scenario we are modeling, something symbolic. It has no basis in reality whatsoever. So how could we deserve the sense of threat? We don't. It's more like we don't deserve this hypothetical scenario at all. That's the truth. We don't deserve to be engaged with this madness of trying to solve an imaginary threat of annihilation to reality. And yet we think we're doing reality a favor. Now God, the Prime Creator, does not interfere with this hypothetical scenario. Why? Because to do so would cause tremendous fear in us, and we would feel that God is attacking us. Because we believe that God is not aware of this upcoming annihilation of reality. And so what we're doing is actually saving the Prime Creator, saving reality, saving ourselves. And so we believe that this working on threat in this world is all important, in this universe. It's supremely important. And if God were to remove problems from this universe, we would literally take that as the most terrible, destructive thing possible. And that literally would take that God is trying to annihilate us, because we believe this universe is the way that we are going to figure out how to protect ourselves from annihilation, and thus so-called protect the Prime Creator from annihilation too. So God knows this and does not change the nature of existence. Does not interfere with the nature of resistance. It continues to be what it is, which is a survival game. It continues that way, will continue that way, whether in 3D or 4D. The difference between 3D and 4D is simply the different tactics that the adaptive survival mechanisms use. 4D has the tactics which are two sides of service to others or service to self, but in sophisticated ways. One is like a hierarchical chain of great efficiency. The other is more of a cooperative situation, like a cooperative hive mind thing. But they're both simply different tactics on how to survive crises. And in 3D, the crises are more individualistic, where we feel we have to individually overcome them. Where in 4D, it's a more cooperative venture. Either you, and the ways that you cooperate are different. So, but SDS and SDS, service to self, service to others, is actually two sides of the same coin. It's just different tactics are being used to try and adaptation to threats of annihilation. That's all that it is. And we don't need either of those. We don't need any work on adaptive survival mechanisms, tactics, to try and survive annihilation, because annihilation is never going to happen in reality. And we are children of reality, and that is our home. Jesus said, "This world is not my kingdom." They said, "Where are you going? You're leaving us. Why? How can you leave your kingdom?" He said, No. "This world is not my kingdom. I'm going to my Father's kingdom. That is the true kingdom. This place," he says, "is a place of darkness and wickedness," which is true. It is a survival game. It is a hypothetical. It is a virtual reality, a virtual reality survival game, where we continually have these challenges, like a video game keeps giving us all these challenges, and we pass one level, it gives us a higher level, a tougher level. We pass that, it gives us a tougher challenge. Really, video games actually mirror what existence is all about. As you try to survive, and they're shooting and attacking you, and you manage to get them first, and then a more difficult challenge comes, and the level of difficulty keeps increasing. That's really exactly what existence is all about. And as we pass one crisis test, we get the next one, which is more difficult. And then the next one, and the next one, and the next one. And it continues on and on and on and on that way. And we're not earning any points with reality at all. Because reality is not asking us to figure out how to survive annihilation, because it knows that is never going to happen. We will never be met with that challenge at all. So it just simply, God does not interfere with this virtual reality game, the survival game. this hypothetical scenario, does not interfere with it. Simply says, you can choose to drop this engagement, drop your engagement, and instead engage with accepting reality as it is. And to help you with that, there is this other realm, which is a problem-free, death-free realm, which maintains the basic context of what we're used to. The trees, the flowers, the grass, the water, the sky, the atmosphere, etc. But it's in a completely immaculate, pristine, problem-free condition. It's never threatened. There's no crises or threats that arise. And I was literally taken in spirit and shown this place, perfectly aware of it, walking around in it, and just saying, wow, what is this place? There's never been any problems here. There's never been any damage or threat I can see. It's amazing. It's a death-free realm. It's a problem-free realm. That is what we're invited to. Otherwise, we'll continue to try to overcome crises and try to annihilate what we see as the wicked, and the wicked will try to annihilate those that it sees as wicked, and there will continue to be conflicts and all sorts of problems with planets, the sun, gravity waves, high energy waves, the sun causing problems with the planet, all sorts of crises and stuff, and we'll desperately try and deal with these crises, and then fourth dimensional entities come into here and say, we know what the crisis is you're facing, we're going to help you survive that crisis. And we say, oh, great, you'll continue on with that without a doubt. That's the only option there is. There's either the hypothetical survival game, or there's accepting reality as it is. Those are the only two options that we have. There aren't any others. And the pathway to accepting reality as it is contains this death-free realm, this problem-free realm. That is part of the path that can be taken. It's also possible to choose the overlay of all of existence and see it that way too, even while you're in this world. That is also possible. It's also possible to wake up from this hypothetical directly in this world. Some have done sort of that through meditation, contemplation. Those are also ways to do it. But this death-free, problem-free realm is there. It is available to everyone. Everyone. There's absolutely, I don't have to determine who's deserving of it or not. Everyone's deserving of it. Everyone. The only problem is so many people feel they're not deserving, because they're told, oh, you did something wrong. You're not good enough. You're not good enough for this realm. Not true. Because as you experience this realm, you automatically feel that there's no need for defense and attack and all this. There's no crises. There's no attempt to annihilate you. So there's no need to develop weapons, defensive systems, all this stuff. You just enjoy it. You just feel incredible bliss and enjoyment. This is just wonderful. Everyone would feel that went there. Everybody. Yet, so how do I convey that you're deserving of it? that's the question. It is it's a tricky thing. It's a difficult thing, and I can only say that for myself, I'm feeling more and more deserving of it, realizing it's not based on anything at all except what I truly am, which is a created aspect of reality, like everyone else. Even though they think they're separated or cast off in the darkness, they're not. They're simply deeply engaged in this hypothetical scenario, working on this threat of annihilation, and they've come up with all sorts of bizarre ways and attempts to deal with annihilation. Really, the diversity in this scenario is incredible. There's just a massive diversity of a huge spectrum of different tactics. Really, there are different tactics being used, incredible diversity of tactics being used to work on this problem of annihilation. It's just a mind-blowing, and we don't have to catalog them. It's not necessary. It is not at all necessary to catalog any of those. There's nothing in the death-free realms that's going to ask you, well, did you catalog all the different ways? No, nothing like that. It just says, welcome, enjoy, you deserve this. This is what you deserve. This will help you. This is easily translatable into accepting reality as it is, fully, with no reservation whatsoever. And that's all there is to it. No tests. There's not, what is it, St. Peter's not at the gates checking to see your resume, see if you get in or not. Absolutely not. Nothing like that. Because you already are totally deserving. And all your supposed undeservingness is merely your struggles in trying to figure out how to adapt or overcome annihilation. And this annihilation is imaginary. So your struggles are also based imaginary. And whatever you did or didn't do, etc., makes no difference. Makes no difference. Final judgment is that you don't need to exercise any judgment. You already are deserving. I have to find some better ways to convey this, because I've been doing this for years and it's still not sinking in. It's still not sinking in. And because the entire scenario here of this existence is based on judgment and what is better, what is worse, what is good, what is bad, what is deserving, what is not, valuing this, valuing, you know, this and that. And it seems totally foreign to us that we deserve something inherently, with something this wonderful inherently. It just seems, no, I'm not good enough for that. I have to have a lot of lifetimes of service to be deserving of this, or a lot of lifetimes of contemplation, or a lot of lifetimes of doing good works and charities, and a lot of lifetimes of education and higher degrees, and I'm not intelligent enough here. I'm be overwhelmed. No, none of that is true. None of it's true. And the most powerful meditation is deservedness meditation, which is why I say the best help we can get is to just hang out with ambassadors of the problem-free realm, ambassadors of certitude, ambassadors of reassurance, those who have accepted reality as it is, because all they do is reassure us that we're deserving. That's all they do, really. They're not cataloging the problems of existence or doing esoteric teachings, how to learn, blah, 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 this. No. They're just conveying, hey, you are worthy right now. You've always been worthy. You're always deserving. And you always will be deserving. And all you have to do is accept this fact. Just accept the fact that it is so. That's all they do. That's all they really do. The real teachers, that's all they really do, is they just reassure you that you're deserving. That is the highest teaching, is deservedness reassurance. Deservedness reassurance is the highest teaching. And I'm only doing this conceptually, so it's not powerful enough. It's helpful for sure, but it's not powerful enough to really connect and permeate you until you feel it, you really know it. So I'm continuing to beat the drum for, we need the ones that can reassure us that we're deserving of this right now, in the future, in the past, always, no matter what. You take the worst person in the world, quote unquote, they're just as deserving as anyone else. Everybody is equally deserving, because it is merely the way to accept reality as it is, which we're all deserving of. We're children of reality, so of course we deserve to experience reality as it is. How could we not be deserving? It's only in our imagination that we feel we're not deserving, because we feel reality is going to be annihilated. So it's a moot point, and we're supposed to work on how to survive annihilation. But that is all insanity. Just because we've engaged with insanity doesn't make us undeserving. Not at all. Not at all. And just because we've engaged in crazy tactics, which we all have been, doesn't make us undeserving at all. And yet, if an ambassador of reassurance of your deservedness comes into this world, people will say, "Oh, I don't deserve that. I mean, let me find some other teacher." But this one's too high. They're too good. They're too great, and the awe factor jumps in there, so it's difficult. But I'm trying to get to that point where I would feel comfortable with that. Say, "Yeah, I deserve this. Absolutely, I deserve it. Of course." How could I not? It's just simply a factual statement. It has nothing to do with bragging or ego or anything. It is simply a factual statement. How can a child of reality not deserve experiencing reality as it is? And being that we have been in this side trip of this hypothetical for so long, we need this halfway house of the death-free, problem-free realm so that we can then easily accept reality as it is. So of course we deserve this expedient. Absolutely do. So again, reassurance of deservedness is really the highest, best teaching. And if you can find a teacher like that, then you are in a great situation, truly a great situation. And I do look at a lot of different teachers. Every day I'm looking for teachers. I'm looking. And I'm looking for that reassurance of deservedness. Simply that, nothing else. I'm not looking for any clever teachings about awareness, consciousness, and all this and all that. I'm not looking for that. Because the issue really is deservedness. Because we will accept what we feel we deserve. And what the teacher has to convey is this profound sense of reassurance that of deservedness, unequivocal, extending to everybody equally. It's not like you're real deserving, but you're not really deserving. And no, none of that. There's this. And I've had experience with such teachers, and Anamayama for one, in the subtle level, and also externally with videos, pictures. I can get it. I realize definitely the reassurance is equal to all. Equal to all, just radiating this reassurance. That's what we need. We really need that at this time. And I'm trying to ramp things up so that when it happens, we can tiptoe in there and say, do I deserve this? I think I do. I'm going to at least check it out and say, yeah, I think I deserve, I believe I deserve this. Not believe, but I factually, I do deserve this. My reason shows me factually I deserve this. Since I'm a child of reality, how can I not deserve this? It's impossible. Absolutely impossible. And so I believe we are ramping up for this. I believe these videos are preparing us for this. But it's at a subtle level. On the external level, we are still dealing with issues of deservedness and talking about them. But underneath, I'm simply saying, it's simply an unescapable fact we deserve it. We are children of reality, not of this hypothetical. Children of this hypothetical gives rise to adaptive survival mechanisms, life forms we call them. Those are just adaptive survival mechanisms. That's not what we are. That's not what we are at all. These are just imaginary adaptive survival mechanisms that are given rise, trying to deal in dealing with crisis and threat to survival, to these adaptive survival mechanisms. They're not what we are. We are spirit. We are the one sonship. We are one with reality. We are children of reality, children of the prime creator. We absolutely deserve to experience reality as it is, which is totally problem-free, totally death-free, and blissful and wonderful beyond what we can even explain. So we absolutely deserve it. That's a fact. Fact, fact, fact. We're only dealing on facts here, not belief, not conjecture, facts. So there's no way that we don't deserve it, ever. No way. It's impossible. So you do deserve it. And if you can glom onto this clarity and you can say and see it for yourself, see, hey, put the dots together. Wait a minute. If I'm a child of reality, and reality can never be threatened in any way, how can I do anything to reality which would make me not deserving experiencing reality as it is? How is that possible? And the answer is it's impossible. But we can mistakenly believe that reality is going to be annihilated based on our desire to change reality, and then feel we need to work on this annihilation and get caught up in the whole valuing system of that. We have got caught up in that, but that doesn't change the fact that we are still children of reality. Reality cannot be annihilated, and we're perfectly deserving to experience reality as it is. That doesn't change the facts at all. It does not. If you can see it, then deep down within you, you say, you know what? I can accept the direct reassurance. I can do it. That's the goal we're reaching for. And so I will continue on pressing towards this goal. All right, that is enough for this one. I'm trying to keep it shorter right now. Very great.